That's what the Patriots is all about, my organization.
Well, there's some good news. I monitor liberal radio, conservative, libertarian, the whole spectrum TV. And in the last month, as the pain has gotten bad enough and as they've stopped denying that we're in an economic freefall because it doesn't work anymore, and as enough people that thought they were part of the power structure feel the pain, they're now admitting not corporations good, welfare people bad, or welfare people good, corporations bad, rich good or rich bad. A more sophisticated reality-based thing is emerging. They're going, wait a minute, there's ultra super rich corporations that pay almost no taxes or none. They use government to get corporate welfare and shut down their competition. And they are setting up a global system to rob us and get rid of the middle class where we fit the bill for everything. And I'm hearing liberals say it. I'm hearing Glenn Beck say it. I'm hearing mainline conservatives say it. I'm hearing Michael Savage say it. And I never heard this even a few months ago. And I'd like to say this show, you know, is putting some of the reality-based talking points out, but others are. And so I'm seeing a real shift where people are saying, wait, we better cut defense, a lot of conservatives led by Rand Paul. We better get out of this empire because it's all over. And the offshore banks, they don't care. They have the 112 points in the IMF World Bank documents that came out in 2002 where they like to suck you dry, then implode you, then bring in austerity that makes it worse, and then offer a new solution, more austerity. Yeah. I mean, folks better understand. You better grow out of your Republican, Democratic, limited, little mindless fairy tale paradigm. You better get religion about world history and world government and what oligarchs do and the same tropisms they set up each time, or it's over. I mean, this is real. We're going into a depression, hyperinflation. They have set up a police state. They are training the neighborhood people to be spies. They are visiting all the major doctors and community leaders to spy on their patients. They visited my dad. They visited other people he works with. They're going to other dentists he knows. I mean, this is a major D-Day level buildup against us. I mean, I'm telling you, I mean, this is real tyranny.
Yeah, and the guys on the right, a lot of them say, oh, you know, we blame government. You know, it's big government's the problem. Guys on the left say, oh, big business is the problem. What they don't understand is that those are two sides of the same coin. When you have the fusion of industry and government, you have fascism. That's exactly what Benito Mussolini defined as fascism, and it is. And that's what we've got, because we have a government that is wholly owned by the biggest business, these oligarchs that you're talking about, the banking empire. And they own our government right now. And so it's not that the government is too big. It's just that the government's in the wrong hands and serves the wrong people. We need a government big enough and strong enough, but most importantly, independent enough to protect the people from those giant corporations. And right now it can't, and it won't, because it doesn't want to, because it's feeding off them.
Well, but then there's the argument of allowing big government to grow, then allowed a big enough government to siphon off our money to the big corporations. But regardless now, these corporations, I mean, what, more than half the top 100 biggest economies are not even countries. They're corporations. Yeah. These have intelligence networks. They have spies in every strata of society. They are government. People need to get that. Yeah. They are sovereign. They operate. They do what they want. They're above the law. And then we're not.
They have no loyalty to our country at all. Most of them don't pay taxes to our country. They've got some rinky-dink headquarters.
It's the Fortune 100 that actually lobbies for higher taxes on Joe Schmo.
Yeah.
I'm sick of it.
Yeah.
I mean, it was the insurance companies. That's how deceptive. Oh, you want socialist health care? Oh, you don't want to help old ladies. You're a racist. Then you get the health care bill written by the insurance companies to cut care, to not let doctors carry out the care, and to make 35 million people buy the insurance, doesn't cover pre-existing conditions. And you've got to have arguments with dumb mainline liberals that think you want to take free health care from somebody. It doesn't exist. It's such a fraud that we're having a debate about health care when it's not. Oh, man.
It is. When you get to health care, my conservative position is, as a conservative, I believe that the only fiscally responsible way to provide health care is to eliminate the profit, the overhead, the red tape, and the interference between doctor and patient of the insurance companies by kicking them out of health care altogether. I would much rather have a single-payer national health system, no insurance companies. The government doesn't run health care. It just does one thing. It pays the bill. And the bill would be about 60% of what it is now, because we'd get rid of all of that profit and overhead.
Well, when you talk about...
I know that's not libertarian, but hey, I swing both ways. A lot of my talks are co-sponsored by the Libertarian Party and the Green
Party. I understand that. Well, look, we already have a form of collectivism. The insurance companies owned by the megabanks have written a system where the profits are private and the loss is public.
Yeah. Socialism for the rich, capitalism for the poor. That's what we've got.
Yeah, and they take our wealth. I'm saying government has become the conduit of that, and the libertarians come in and say, privatize. Well, now you've just got a new government called a corporation over you who even jacks it up more.
You're right. Absolutely. Absolutely.
But see, I mean, again, they make it so simple. Liberal, conservative, libertarian.
Yeah,
but
it's not.
You have to debate what you're dealing with.
Yeah.
What these things really are, not their definitions. Dr. Bowman, but looking at where we are now, I mean, do you have any doubt that the meltdown is accelerating?
No, of course it's the only thing that you can do where we are. The meltdown is accelerating, just like the one at Fukushima. What we have to do is understand what we can do about it. And the American people, workers, have to understand that they're being robbed blind. They complain about the taxes that are taken out of their paycheck. What they don't understand is that the corporations tax them 20 times as heavily as the government by taking these huge amounts for overhead and profit out of the money that we, the people, create with our labor. Every hour of our labor, we create some $250 in wealth. So how come take-home pay is $8 an hour? Well, the government takes $2. Okay, that would make it 10. What happened to the other $240? The corporations stole it. That's what happened to it. And workers have to understand that.
Well, they've created an unfair playing field by constantly having the laws written to shut down their competition.
Yeah, and that's, they use the government for their purposes so that the government is no longer protecting us from them, like Teddy Roosevelt tried to do and like FDR tried to do. Both parties, you know, conservative and liberal, doesn't matter. Both parties for ages have recognized the danger of the corporations getting too much power. Heck, Thomas Jefferson talked about it.
Again, there's the mega corporations that have all the lawyers and write the loopholes. They are the ones that get away with murder.
Yeah, we're not talking about mom and pop grocery stores here.
No, exactly. Who have a corporation for liability. So if somebody slips and breaks their ankle, they can't take, you know, Susie's college money.
Yeah.
And again, as people send me emails saying, well, you're saying all corporations are bad. No, folks, we're not saying that. Again, people see things through a one-dimensional lens. We've got to start trying to really see things in a more complex 360 view. Colonel Bob Bowman, by the way, speaking live tomorrow night in Austin. He's also speaking at Truth Seekers. That's public, but with Randall Mott, great guy, but I'm not sure where they're meeting right now. But we'll tell you tomorrow night where he's meeting. We got five more minutes here with Dr. Bob Bowman, thepatriots.us. And then Tarpley's going to pop back in because we ran out of time with him to finish up his economic breakdown of just how serious things are going. And I remember him years ago saying, first they'll try to bring down Europe, then the contagion will spread to the West. It's now begun. A very serious situation. Colonel Bob Bowman is going to be speaking tomorrow night at Brave New Books in Austin, Texas, down off Guadalupe Street, 1904 Guadalupe Street. Really needs no introduction for Austinites. Get there early because it only holds about 150 people, and that'll be Saturday, April 30th, 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Central. Always great to hear him uninterrupted by the radio breaks and things, so folks can check that out. Dr. Bowman, I mean, the crisis isn't approaching. It's here, kind of like a fire in a house. It's now, you know, the house is on fire. If it continues, the whole house is going to burn down. How do you see the globalists, the social engineers, the oligarchy striking back? I see false flag written all over the place, and I see these White House advisors saying how great this would be. and to really accelerate their new wars and their domestic crackdown.
Yeah, we have to understand that the entire war on terror is phony, up one side and down the other. Not just because 9/11 was a lie, you know, we all know that. But beyond that, that the real reasons for Iraq and for Afghanistan had nothing to do with 9/11. Those wars were planned way in advance before 9/11, planned in detail, pushed for by, you know, the PNAC crowd, Wolfowitz and Pearl and Zelikow and Cheney and, you know, all the traitors. So it's pursuit of empire. We have to end that. We have to bring our brave young men and women home while they're still alive. We have to start using the money to serve the people of this country. We need to end the Fed, abolish the Fed, get rid of that debt to the Fed. We need to nationalize insolvent banks, not bail them out. You know, if they're too big to fail, they're too big to exist. We used to have antitrust laws in this country, and they were to protect business.
And it turned out in the analysis, even in BBC had to admit it, that in Ireland and Iceland, they've analyzed over 90% of the debt is the private banks who were there posing as the saviors. Folks, we don't owe this. It's made up, most of it.
Yeah, yeah. And so we need to do things differently. The United States and all its individual states should be like North Dakota, who has their own bank, not for profit. North Dakota, the state, has no debt. People there can get loans from the state bank.
And they have bigger families.
And, you know,
it's a policy of life on a policy of death.
We've got to get rid of the Fed, the whole debt-based monetary system, everything associated with it. We have to go back to my old boss, Eisenhower, and rethink his statement about the power of the military-industrial complex. And we know that it, too, is owned by...
Yeah, they've sold it that you're a commie, you're a wimp, you're whatever, if you don't love the military-industrial complex. Folks, it controls almost all research, funding, and it's run by foreign corporations that are destroying every canon of the Bill of Rights and Constitution. America is the founding documents and the ideas of liberty and our culture and our history of freedom. It's not whatever the corporations package up and wrap in an American flag.
Yeah,
they could have little cyanide pills with American flags on them.
We have given up most of the rights that were given to us by this Constitution and Bill of Rights by letting them pass these screwy, misnamed Patriot Act and Military Commissions Act. They take our rights away unconstitutionally. You know, you can't take these rights away by passing...
That's right. It's treason. Bob Bowman?
Some puppet dictator.
Thank you so much for joining us. Visit Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. When you're on the site, you can also tune in 24 hours a day to my daily radio broadcast. There's also a free iPhone app to listen to the syndicated radio show when and where you want.